Avonlea was a good field for an evangelist. The Reverend Geoffrey Mountain, who came to assist the Avonlea minister in revivifying the dry bones thereof, knew this and reveled in the knowledge. It was not often that such a virgin parish could be found nowadays, with scores of impressionable, unspoiled souls on which fervid oratory could play skilfully, as a master on a mighty organ, until every note in them thrilled to life and utterance. The Reverend Geoffrey Mountain was a good man, of the earth, earthy, to be sure, but with an unquestionable sincerity of belief and purpose, which went far to counterbalance the sensationalism of some of his methods. He was large and handsome, with a marvelously sweet and winning voice, a voice that could melt into irresistible tenderness, or swell into sonorous appeal and condemnation, or ring like a trumpet calling to battle. His frequent grammatical errors and lapses into vulgarity counted for nothing against its charm, and the most commonplace words in the world could have borrowed much of the power of real oratory from its magic. He knew its value and used it effectively, perhaps even ostentatiously. Geoffrey Mountain's religion and methods, like the man himself, were showy, but of their kind, sincere, and, though the good he accomplished might not be unmixed, it was a quantity to be reckoned with. So the Reverend Geoffrey Mountain came to Avonlea, conquering and to conquer. Night after night the church was crowded with eager listeners, who hung breathlessly on his words, and wept and thrilled and exulted as he willed. Into many young souls his appeals and warnings burned their way, and each night they rose for prayer in response to his invitation. Older Christians, too, took on a new lease of intensity, and even the unregenerate and the scoffers found a certain fascination in the meetings. Threading through it all, for old and young, converted and unconverted, was an unacknowledged feeling for religious dissipation.